Hello friends, let us today discuss on the benefits and importance of strategic management. As in the previous classes, we have discussed that what is strategic management. So in that we have seen that strategic management is something which decides the long-term goal of the organization. It holds lot many of importance to the organization. For preparing an effective strategy, the organization should strive hard so that it can prepare a strategy which will help the organization to direct its efforts towards the attainment of organization goals. Let us discuss some of the key benefits that an organization enjoys if it prepares an effective strategy. The first one is that it helps the organization to be proactive than reactive in preparing the futures or planning the future goal of the organization or shaping the future of the organization. So what is this proactive? It means that as I said here in the strategic management, what they will do that strategic management analyze the environmental factors or it predicts the future activities which helps the organization to be proactive. Proactive in the sense that it makes the organization to be ready for the changes that take place in the organization and adopt the changes effectively than reacting on the situation when it arises. So it helps the organization to be effectively act on the changes which take place in the environmental factors. Next is that it helps the organization or it provides the organization the roadmap as a direction for the attainment of organizational goals. It helps an organization to identify where the organization is and where the organization wants to go. Once that is identified, that is where the organization is and where the organization wants to go, the strategy provides that direction in the form of roadmap. So it shows the route through which the organization should go through so that it can attain the organization goals in an effective way. It helps the organization to utilize the resources in a best possible way. I said you have to here for preparing a strategy, we have to evaluate the environmental factors. We have to know the factors which favors the organization and which unfavors the organization. Once it has been prepared, you can make the better use of the resources according to that factors. Once you analyze the factors which create favor for your organization, so with the available resources, you can take that favorable factors in an effective way. Then what is that it helps the organization to anticipate the change and be prepared to manage it. Once the environmental factors, when you analyze, you can see that as the characteristics specified that it is future oriented. So once the activity is future oriented, it helps the organization to anticipate that in future the change may take place. And the major part of business activity or environmental activity is that it is a dynamic process. A dynamic process indicates that a change can take place at any point of time. So anticipating change helps the organization or predicting the change helps the organization to adopt that changes effectively. And it helps the organization to be prepared for adopting that changes in an effective way. Next, it helps the organization to respond to the environmental changes in a better way. It helps the organization to respond to the environmental changes in a better way means that as I said, the internal and external factors which create a which pose a threat for the organization, the factors which affects the organizational activities. See here, this internal factor which I specified, it may be controllable, that is, it is controlled in the organization as it is within the organization, but the external factors which is there, that is uncontrollable as it is outside the organization. So if you identify these changes or if you are prepared for that changes, it helps the organization to adopt that changes effectively and carry out the organization activities effectively. Here again, next, it helps to it minimize the chances of mistakes and unpleasant surprises. As we are predicting the futures or as we are forecasting the future goal of the organization, we are checking into the changes that take place in the environment. We can avoid the mistakes that take place because as I said, when the change take place, if you are preparing for the strategy, then it will not be effective. You should be prepared with the strategy with a scope with the hope that changes may take place, and if this change take place, how you should match your strategy with that changes. So if it is there, then you can avoid the unpleasant surprises which take place in the organization, which affects the organizational goals. A effective strategy, the next advantage is that a effective strategy helps the organization to provide a effective direction and objectives to the employees to carry out the organizational objectives. It specifies that what is the objective for which the organization set up, so employee knows that objectives for which strategy is been formulated, and not only that objectives, it provides a direction for the employees to attaining that organizational goals in an effective way. The direction helps to know that how the strategy should be implemented so that the results can be attained in an effective way. Next is that it helps the organization to predict the future events that affects the vision, mission and objectives of the organization. I said it is focused towards the long-term activities of the organization. Organization activity is a continuous process which is being carried out for the attainment of long-term goals. So when long-term goals take place, you have visions for the organization, you need to have a missionary statement, you need to have objectives. So predicting that changes that take place in the organization or that take place in the environmental factors that may affect your visionary statement or your mission or the objectives, that should be considered so that you can create that changes and adopt that changes accordingly. Then it helps the organization to know the purpose of the organization. Okay, so that is it gives a clear instruction of what is the purpose for which the organization exists, why the organization exists. So according to that existence, you can prepare that, okay, what is the purpose for which it is exist, where the organization want to take its activity, where it is rightly placed and where it want to go, all that will be specified under an effective strategy. Then is that it helps the each individual in the organization to know that what they are working for and what is expected from each SBU. What is this SBU? Is the strategic business unit, that is each business unit, what is expected from, like when strategy is being formulated, it is being formulated in different levels, that is corporate level, your business level and your SBU level, that is how corporate plan should be for strategy, how business plan should be for the strategy, and how that strategic business unit should be. So as I said, this levels decides that how the strategy should be formulated and implemented in an effective way. Next is that it helps the organization to predict the uncertainty in the business. So identify the uncertainties involved in the business. As I said, it is future oriented. The activity is taken for the future goals. So it helps the organization to predict that changes which take place in the environmental factors. And it makes the strategy flexible so that it can adopt or it can match up with that uncertainty which take place in the business. Every business activity is uncertain only because you cannot predict that what is going to happen tomorrow or today or even a fraction of second, what are the changes that take place in the market. So to match up with this uncertainty, every organization need to prepare a strategy in a flexible way so that the uncertainty which take place in the business can be adopted in an easy way for attainment of the performance of the organization. Next is that it helps the organization to create a link between the long-term and short-term goal of the organization. Strategy, as I said, it is being prepared with the vision of long-term attainment of organization goals. It wants to take the organization for a long run. For attaining that long run, you need to prepare the short-term organization plans too. Here, that is what we said about the vision and the objectives and goals of the organization. So the objectives and goals which has been prepared as a short-term planning for the organization, that should match with the vision of the organization. So it takes the organization to match the organizational activities with the long-term goals and the short-term goals of the organization. Next is that it facilitates control. Strategic management helps the organization to have an effective control on the organizational activities. Strategy can be implemented effectively only if you have a control over the activities. As I said, when the strategy is being formulated, it needs to be put into implementation, that is into action. So if you stop there, you cannot see the results of the organization. So you need to have a proper evaluation and control over the strategy. So once you have that evaluation and control over the strategy, you can see that what are all the changes that is needed so that you can attain the organization goals in an effective way. Next and the last one is that it facilitates measurement. That is, measurement means it helps the organization to measure the result of the organization. So you need to know that whether the strategy which has been implemented help the organization to attain the organization goals in an effective way, or the vision which you have framed that has attained or not. So the organization helps to measurement means here how you will measure. The organization need to set a standard, that this is the standard for which you have to get the result of the organization. Once you set a standard, you can measure the result of the organization, because you can compare the actual result of the organization with that standard. When you compare it, the gap which you get or the result which you get, that indicates the effectiveness of strategy. If your actual result is above the standard, it shows that your strategy has been implemented in an effective way and that is work out for the attainment of organization goals. And if your result is below the standard, it indicates that you need to look into the changes of the strategy, or you have to restructure the strategy according to the change which has taken place in the environment. See friends, all these are the benefit or the importance that a strategic management gives for the organization. So when a strategic management is being formulated, it takes into consideration all these characteristics and benefits which helps the organization to create a proper vision or a long-term goal of the organization, and create a direction for preparing that strategy which will help the organization to attain the organizational goals or perform in an effective way to create a competitive advantages. Friends, let us discuss on the process of strategic management in next classes. Thank you.